Right, so you can start the timer now. I'll try and finish earlier than Parul because I think I can rest my case earlier. Right. So the precision pulsed capsulotomy with the Zepto, what is it? You're looking at a simple handheld instrument which has got on its tip, it's got a cutting element which is nynitol, which is associated with another suction cup to it. So it's actually this simple. When you introduce it through a 2.8 incision and you center it, yes, on the visual axis, just on the Purkinje images, all it does is it sits on the anterior capsule, gives you the perfect apposition, the perfect suction, and finally, then all you do is you have a series of multiple low energy bursts, which ends up giving you an instantaneous, simultaneous, mechanical 360-degree split. So the advantage of this, I think, is because there is one big thing, that is reproducibility. So reproducibly, it's giving you a quick, consistently sized, circular, a fairly well-centered capsulotomy, which is strong, very important, strong, and tear-resistant. The big advantage, again, with this comes in the fact that irrespective of your pupil size, the status of clarity of the cornea, the density of the lens, or whether it's intumescent or not, and irrespective of the zonular stability, you're able to get a good cut. It's an FDA-approved gadget. It's absolutely safe, and there is no thermal damage involved here. And this single handheld disposable handpiece and this instrument is extremely easy to use. There is not much of a learning curve here at all. It is, I've actually done it in several cases, and I find it's really quick to learn. And when you consider, and the concerns about centration are not too much, too bad a deal, because all you need to do is when the patient's looking straight up, you center it on the center of the visual axis. I think the big advantage of Zepto also comes in the fact that unlike Femto, well, I come to that later, there is no break in your workflow. You are operating, you're just adding another step into your routine surgery in the same OT. There is no increase in surgical time. The setup is pretty quick and really doesn't take too much. Regarding an assistant, you also need your assistants to, you know, turn on the microscope light and stuff like that. So they're just setting it up and it really takes more. And I think the biggest advantage comes here. When you actually look at the edge of the Zepto, what you eventually end up with is the undersurface of the capsule that rounds upwards, and you have a round, functional, smooth, intact edge which is defect-free. Various studies have compared, I mean, the femtorexis studies compared on porcine eyes. This is a Thompson study where they compared age-matched normal eyes, and they found that the strength, overall strength of the rexis edge is almost 7 times stronger than that of the others. And when you look at challenging situations, you need to understand this, that if you've got a subluxated cataract, as long as you can figure out the extent of subluxation, you are able to center it on the center of the subluxated cataract, however eccentric it may be, you're okay, you can still get a cut, okay? If you've got a pupil that is small and an intumescent cataract, you don't need to be worried because you're not using light to go through to create that cut. Even if you do have a small pupil, much smaller than this as well, it can be safely passed under the pupillary edge. There is no damage to your undersurface of the iris as well. Again, in the intumescent cataract, you get an instantaneous, it's not a sequential cut which you get in femto, and you just get that instantaneous cut, giving you the stability that you require for the rest of your surgery. If you have a corneal opacity, you can even put a limbal light pipe, have a look. Through that opacity, you can go ahead and create your cut. There's no major investment. Yes, the initial equipment costs you something. You can also bundle this with lenses where every fourth lens you can get if you use it with the company that promotes it, you don't even have to pay for it. And then you have an option of choosing it, whether you want to integrate it for each and every one of your case, for premium IOLs, or for different cases. Now, what happens with Femto? I mean, we know there is no doubt the biggest excitement when Femto came up was for its ability to give you the perfect cut and the perfect rexis. And agreed, you get that perfect cut, which is round, centered, et cetera, et cetera. But is it really the next big thing? I don't think so. Because one, the cut that you get with the Femto rexis is not instantaneous. It's a sequential circular capsulotomy. Agreed, it happens fast. And you can predict its size, circularity, and centration. But there are limitations. The inconsistency comes in the fact that if you've got these major movements of the eyes, or in an intermittent cataract, which is the biggest challenge for even the most experienced of surgeons. Once you make that cut within an intermittent cataract, the initial cut with the femto and the chamber shallows because the milk comes out, you're going to end up with aberrant laser shots. This leaves behind focal areas of weak capsule, which can eventually end up in a compromised capsulotomy, which is what you didn't want in the first place. The edge created by the femto looks like thousands of little can opener openings, each of which could have a propensity of moving out into the periphery. And the limitations do, if you've got a very, very small pupil, what are you going to do? If you've got a corneal opacity, what are you going to do? If you've got a very, very gross subluxation, there's no way you can get a cut, a rexus. And you want a stable rexus if you're trying to manage a challenging case like a gross subluxation. The time goes up from 11 to 13 minutes more when you do a femto capsulotomy, a femto platform. You may need to move between theaters, and it's an additional step. And there's a cost of equipment, there's a cost of maintenance, there's a cost of per case fees, and therefore all of which gives you a serious pressure to perform. And therefore, to me, a femto is just a white elephant, which is a possession entailing great expense disproportionate to its usefulness or value to the owner. Thank you.